content over everything.
Starving people, or people in jeeps with a rag around their head. I started looking at Africa, yeah. I started thinking negatively about the whole continent. And saying I believe it was messed up. I truly believe, if you keep on portraying women in movies and videos as bums and chests, you stop seeing them as humans and start seeing them as objects. And what happens is that's why I think it's easier. Now, I'm not, before anyone takes my words and take it out of context, I'm not saying guys are not responsible. They're responsible. They're the main responsible ones. They're fully responsible.
Right.
But when guys just keep on seeing, especially, and I think music videos are more important than movies, because one, music videos are like little movies now. Yes, and you spend more time with it than you would watching a movie.
Yeah.
The amount of music videos a person watches compared to a movie.
Influence is bigger.
Yeah. So what I would say is that when the guys are just watching chest bump, this and the other, when he sees them walking the street in stretch jeans, and women are responsible when they're wearing trousers that are 10 times too small for them.
He spoke about feminism.
Yeah. But this is the part of it. If women start doing that, they're gonna see it. They're gonna get misinformed. They're gonna think, because I'm getting attention, like feminism, because I'm getting attention, that means guys respect them. But when they get pregnant and guys leave them, then they're gonna realize it wasn't really respect. It was just men like women.
Yeah. So feminism, how it's explained, is women want the same rights as men, right? And as that's gone by, they want to be able to do the same thing men have historically done.
Yeah.
So I think what the brother here is saying is that is a problem, right?
Yeah. But secularism doesn't say so, because there's no morality.
Well, no one's talking about secularism, right or wrong.
I don't know about your definition.
What would you say we live by in London?
Secularism is where
all religions are permitted.
Do you know what secular, the word actually means away from God. If you get a dictionary.
Oh, never mind. Yeah, I'm just
without God. I'm asking you, what do you, because I don't want to put words in your mouth.
Sure.
What do you believe we live by in this country?
Okay, but we have to get to that, is the political philosophy. Okay,
yeah.
Now you can go.
What do you believe? Because I don't want to misquote you. I believe we believe we're a mixer of atheism, secularism, and capitalism. Like basically YOLO.
Right. Okay. So you're asking me about how do we have morality here in the UK? And I would say that it's going to be difficult to articulate myself on this one, man. Right?
We all try.
I know, but I got to be accurate, because there's many things that I observe in our society that I don't like at all, man. I don't rep at all. Things that I think are reprehensible, right? On all sides. And I don't know what to do about that. But one thing I know for sure is I can't force it upon others. My view.
How do I influence society
in a benevolent way to make it better? Again, I don't know. I've got to think about it. Because there's many things. Like, if you look at the collapse of the family in the UK, like the traditional, like the non-immigrant family, it's collapsed. Completely collapsed. You've got people dying in old folks' homes. You've got grandparents freezing to death in the winter. Nobody cares. Well, this is my perspective. It's my conception of morality, right? I'm not a religious man. I've got my own conceptions about spirituality and whatever. And I don't need that to be imposed upon me to have my own view, right? But can I impose it upon others? No, it's tricky, and I don't know why it's gone into decline. I'm not sure if you're familiar with nihilism. You heard of the term? Because nihilism is something that's gripped the West, as in the Western part of the world, for the last 200 years, and it's caused, being part of the cause of the massive genocides and wars that we've had, and the collapse of this society, because there is no value. The whole idea of postmodernist value is that nothing has value, and I agree, it's dangerous as hell, it's really, really bad, but I don't know how to fix it, and I don't believe that dogmatic religion put on it is a hot fix.
Can I
answer
this?
Even with Islam, we say, it's clear, with Islam, not everybody is going to hear the message. Everyone who has heard the message isn't going to become Islamic. So if we're going to talk about solving the solution within the black community, we already know from the start that a black person is going to become Muslim. So how are you going to solve the solution away from Islam? That's my thing. Now, we can say Islam's the way. I believe it, you believe that's why they're Muslim. But everybody else out here, this brother just told you, he's not going to become Muslim. Not everybody else in the world is going to become Muslim. But the issue is still there. So that's the question that I want to get to. When it comes to this problem, there are solutions. I believe David has already put forward that Islam's the way, Christianity's the way. Different people can have different ways for themselves. However, we need to find a way where we encourage the people to do the best, rather than encouraging people, like you say, to have the YOLO attitude.
Because you know, that's something that I actually value, I actually respect a lot about I've made this a generalization about Muslim culture. Yeah, you know what? My best friend's Muslim. I have many Muslim friends.
No, I know what you're saying. Because you hesitated. You wanted to say Muslim, you hesitated a bit.
No, you don't know me, man. You don't know me. So
okay, I apologize.
You're putting two suppositions.
I apologize for misreading.
Yeah, I've had my life saved by Muslims. For real.
So,
I've had a lot of adventures you might not believe. I lived in Muslim countries for a while. Very dangerous ones, too. But that's another story. In any case, there's many things that I value about keeping the family structure and having these. It has problems too, no doubt, but it has a deep structure that I think all people find appealing. One thing you'll find most people disagree with, they're like, oh, nobody talks to anybody, everybody's so hostile, everybody pushes everyone, everyone's on the phone. Everybody thinks that, but people still do it. Where many people are hypocrites. I don't know how to get a solution, but the lack of direction, the lack of meaning is prevalent, man. It's prevalent. I don't believe that religion is the way. I believe enlightening our thought is the way, man.
That's what I'm saying. You see this? Can I answer that and then come back to you? Can I reply to this?
He hasn't spoken.
No. He speak, but I'll come to you.
I think this is going in the direction of theocracy. Do you believe that theocracy is the right direction?
That's what I'm trying to say. I never said words. I keep on saying it, but no one's listening. I'm not saying you should have Sharia law in this country. Yeah. I'm not saying that you should be Muslim. I gave how
moral,
living on both sides, yeah? How Islam, there's no Sharia law here. Islam has benefited me as a person, yes? Like I said, I've been married for 11 years. I wouldn't want to be married and I've got three kids. I don't think I'd be married, yeah? And most probably, if I was not Muslim, I wouldn't be married, yes? No, I definitely wouldn't be married because I would have seen marriage as a burden, yes? And secondly, it'd be a lot easier for me to go, as a young person, to go having pleasure and just ignoring if I got a girl pregnant itself. I never said that no one should become Muslim. I said, this is the positive things that I think Islam are. I didn't say you should take it, I'm saying. But
he's saying that he doesn't see.
Yeah, I'm not saying you should have a channel.
Yeah, right? To make the position feel better.
But if you don't,
explain why you've always objected to this word religion.
No, it's not that I object to the word religion. So that's wrong. But I understand you want me to talk about it, so I will.
Yes.
But okay, a couple of reasons. One, if it's a totalizing belief system, I believe it's not good for us, man. It's not good for us as a species because, as you say, things are going to get worse. Things are going to change. Life's going to change. Planet's going to change. We discover new technology. What about AI? That's just getting developed. What about automation, AI, cloning, genetic engineering, embryology? That's just going to change our entire world. It already has. It's already in. I'm a biologist, like I said. Now that's massive. Now can you use the legal systems and the law and morality systems of an ancient time to apply to a modern world of humans that are advancing forward? It doesn't discredit.
But you're saying,
I want to keep going. I didn't finish my answer.
Sorry.
Right? Because it doesn't discredit some of the moral groundings of ancient beliefs. It doesn't. But it doesn't mean that all of. I would argue it doesn't mean that all of them can be applied towards the future. Now, if it's totalizing, it means it knows all. It has all the answers. It can't be questioned. That's incredibly dangerous. People disagree. You should disagree. We need to think. It's like freedom of speech. If you don't have freedom of speech, you can't discuss ideas. You can't discuss ideas. You've got no progress.
Okay, but you said this is what I'm just saying. But the thing is this, you're saying you ain't even got a solution. So the reality of the thing is, what you're saying is this. First of all, I'm not saying you should be Muslim, but I'm saying this to you. If you say you don't have a solution, but you see many things that Islam says that are good, you should take the positive things. Also, secondly, you're saying it came from an ancient time. You're assuming that the ideas came from men's minds, and that's why it's not good to have them, because they're... It was a long time ago. Now we've got Wi-Fi and we've got...
You said some of them should be applied.
Excuse me. Yes. First of all, we believe our religion is from the Creator, yes?
Yep.
So we don't believe it came from Muhammad back in 49. We believe it came from the eternal being that knows everything, yes? So what I'm trying to say to you, and just because something is old, don't mean it's wrong. Treating your mother good is an ancient, backdated rule. It should stay until the future of eternity, yes?
He's raised a good point. The point is, times are changing. Does the religious of the past affect the king? So for example, you could brush past this point, but you know like in Saudi Arabia, yeah. Women weren't allowed to drive for a school park.
But was that cultural? But was that cultural? Or was it religious?
But what I'm saying is, and this is a clear definition where, for example, a futuristic book says, in the future, there's going to be things called cars, you can drive it.
But because it was written in the past when it was made, they have to mention it. I think that's what the brand is.
Yeah, okay, so, and also about eliminating genetic diseases. We can do that now. We can take it out. Is that allowed?
Okay.
Do we know?
Okay.
I don't know.
So the question, I mean, yeah. Okay, so the rule should be, if something is a good rule, ancient or print or modern, it should be used.
But then who defines good law, eh?
No, what I'm trying to say to you, according to you, if a rule is according to you, I'm not talking about God or Muslims.
Right.
If you believe a rule is good, whether it's ancient or whether it's present or modern, you should use it, yes?
I should use it.
Okay, so I can say to you, look, in a Muslim country, yes, we don't have an epidemic of single mothers. We don't have an epidemic of runaway fathers. We don't have an epidemic, yeah, of alcoholism. We don't have an epidemic of drug problems. So what I'm trying to say to you is, in a Muslim country, alhamdulillah, the family stable. You don't have like you have it. Yes, here you have Wi-Fi, you have buses, you have iPhones and all this stuff there. Yes, but you have an epidemic of single fathers, runaway fathers, and single mothers, and you have an epidemic of drugs, and you have an epidemic of alcoholism.
Yeah, yeah.
And look, certain things in the Muslim countries will never happen. The other day, or many times, you see young people, young kids, yeah, like getting on the bus, and they might use the Esther card from their mum, yeah, and you say to them, F you, this, that, be quiet. You can call these countries backwards or whatever, they're never going to speak to their mother like that, yeah? In this country, we have all this technology and all this hi-fi advanced technology.
Yeah.
But you'll find young, strong men, yeah, that will see an old woman who's got a pension, yeah, and that young, strong guy, yeah, will punch her and leave her black and we bust her up and take her money just so we can get some designer clothes and stuff. You will never find that in the Eastern countries. So
I wouldn't say never, man.
Excuse me. No, they won't. Excuse me.
There's no crime.
Excuse me. I never said there's crime.
Well,
did I say there's no crime in the Western countries?
You have to establish the source.
No, but I never said what
you're saying. No, the thing is, no crime.
I'd say to you.
Your conversation about, and one thing we have to understand is, we haven't. So the reason why you validate the book is because your belief comes from the person in question.
Yes.
This individual, I assume, doesn't believe in such a thing exists. Right? Therefore, meaning. The reason
some kind of reality, but you have to think, how would they, if they were to come into presence with what you believe, how would they react? He said, if he was spoke to a person who identified as the God of the universe, he would think he's going mad. So that's where that would be
interesting. If that happens, man.
That's what I would say to you.
People get voices in their head all the time.
Right. And that's what I'm saying to you, is that me, I have two ways, because I'm a convert to Islam, I have two projects. Like, sometimes I'm just here in this park, and what is it? Because I want good for all human beings, whether atheist, black, white, or this, that, and the other, and so forth. And what I do, I just speak to them about Islam and our concept of God. Because as a human being, I do believe in Islam. I do believe that God, because he provided the sun, the moon, and all these kind of things for us, our eyesight, oxygen, and food, and all this kind of stuff.
Diseases, illness, genetic.
Hold on.
All the good and bad things.
Hold on. All the good and bad things, yes? But what I'm trying to say to you, as a human being, yes, what I'm trying to say to you, are you blessed? Do you believe your life is blessed?
I don't know what it means, blessed.
Do you appreciate life?
Do I appreciate life?
Yeah.
I would say yes, because of the experiences that I've had.
Okay, so what I'm trying to say to you, this is me, I'm not saying you have to believe this. What I do is, because as humans, Raven's someone I like very much. Yeah, as him, I don't see him as a religious person, but I like him as a person, his mannerisms and so forth. People I meet in the park, even sometimes people I don't know. So I just speak to them about what I believe, and I say, look, so I was a human being like you. This is my concept of God. I believe all the prophets were Muslims and so forth,
right.
And I believe Islam is true. And this is what I say to them. I don't tell them the Quran is the truth. I say to them, read the Quran for yourself. Either you're going to believe it's from the Creator, or that being, whatever you want to put it, or not. And that's it, I leave it there.
Yeah.
Because I want good for them, and I believe that if they become Muslim, if they implement Islam in their life, they will get lots of good things. But I also have another project called Street Odin, where I talk to you from Kansas stated that sometimes I use religious stuff, sometimes I just use logical stuff, and I reach them. Why? Because I was that person who was for knowing, and it might not be a religion, but it was a philosophy that I lived by.
Aye.
Yes, and I actually took the ethics on board. Like, I thought it was normal to go to go in and out of police station and probation and community service, because I was told that I weren't worth anything.
It's
better to be on road with material things. Sorry, it's either you be on road with material things, or it's okay to be locked up 23 hours a day. So what I'm trying to say to you, in wrapping up, is that, like,
I'm not forced to be Muslim. I believe good Islam is the truth, and I believe it's the thing. But obviously, you don't believe in Islam. But if you say you don't have a solution to the problem, what you should, I'd say you should do, and you're not religious, you should look at our arguments from all different people.
I do. That's why I'm here.
And if it is ancient,
I'm sure I'm open.
Yes. And if, no, I'm telling you, that's why we have this discussion. Even if it's ancient and it's from Islam, but it makes sense, then you should adopt.
That's what I was going to say to you.
Yeah.
Like a secular person could adopt the core principles of Islam without being Islamic, without believing in God. I could follow all of the things that you said, like in terms of dating, without fornication, and not having sex before marriage, all these kind of things. There's plenty of secular people that follow these principles that don't believe in God.
I disagree with religions that follow the same things.
I disagree with you. Do you know why? Because, like I said, Muslims, I don't believe that Muslims are exceptionally good people, and we have our bad Muslims. I'm sure you know there's Muslim drug dealers, there's Muslim killers, there's Muslim that do bad, yes? Okay. Well, I'm just saying there is, yes? Go edge of the road, you'll see Muslims doing a lot of Islamic things. But I'm saying to you, the average human being, yes? It's not that average. The reason why we have many young Muslims, yeah, who come from council estates and this, that and the other, who are 19 years old and they're married, yeah, and 19 years old and going back to education, who can be married from 19 for 10, 15, 20 years until death, yeah? It's not because they're good human beings. It's because they follow what Islam is, the guidelines of Islam. So for example, yes, it's true, you can be a person, yes, who's not a Muslim, and you could feel hypothetically go clubbing and if you get a girl get pregnant. But I'm saying the really because of free
he's saying
no. Okay, tell me this. How many Muslims, yes, how many guys do you know? Yes? That are 19 that are married.
That are 19 and that are married?
I know many. I can give you 10. I can give you maybe even 100.
What does that have to do with anything?
I wouldn't say okay, marriage is model by itself.
Yes, I'm saying.
Okay, what I'm trying to say to you?
I don't know any, by the way. I don't know anybody.
Okay. That's what I'm trying to say. In reality, take council of states then. Like I'm saying, we're in London now and we're not living by Islamic law or Islam. But most fathers are not. If you go to council of state and you see 10 boys and you ask them, do you know your father? No. So what I'm trying to say, you've got secular laws and you can live by secular laws, and if you wait to discipline yourself, you could have a girlfriend if you're not going to have a wife and be married, stay with the same girl for the whole of life. But that's not happening. Why is that not happening?
That's a good question. It's why has a society changed in the form it has? It's a good question.
Do you know why it's not happening? The reason why you're not happening is because you're living your own way. You're living by your own man-made religion, philosophy, ideologies. And what is that when people say, I'm not saying this about anyone that says they're spiritual here, I'm not talking about people here there, but I'm used to this. When I was thinking about becoming Muslim, I thought about this. Why don't I just believe? Because what makes someone a Muslim is believing in a perfect God that's not a man, a statue, an animal, or has human thoughts, resting, hungry. I said, why don't I just believe in that one God, yes? And just be a spiritual person. But the reality is that I know myself, and if I just want to be a spiritual person, I'm not going to put anything in my religion or my idea or my way of life, yeah, that is an inconvenience to me. So my life before I woke up, this is how it was, yeah. I had a music set beside my bed. When I woke up, before my eyes even opened, I press play. You know, Tupac's Hit Him Up come out. A million swear words, this man about his sickle cell and this, like, cuss, kill him, stab him. And then when my eyes open, build up a spliff. The only time I really turn to God is when someone in my family gets cancer. For some reason, I promise I'll pray or I'll fast or something. Why? Because something happened in my family that was serious and out of my hands. So I claim to be spiritual, but I use God like a spare wheel. When I get into a problem, then I become spiritual. But apart from that, it's about my enjoyment. I'm not going to be married, yes? I'm not going to stop bunning. I'm gonna have my own religion that's convenient to me. So the problem is that if I'm a spiritual person and I get a girl pregnant, it's gonna be hard for me to follow the responsibility. Why? Because I'm free and I enjoy my freedom.
But does that answer his question, bro? Right? Like, yeah. The question that they asked him was, Islam has a way of being.
Yeah.
Could they adopt the Islamic ways of life and do exactly what you're doing? They just don't believe what you believe.
Yeah. Yeah,
because brother,
they have it though.
Can I say though?
You can do it though.
Can I say though? A lot of things. Like I said, I agree with a lot of things that you do. Like I don't do drugs. I don't listen to like violent music. I don't sleep around. I don't get women pregnant. I don't do a lot of things that Muslims do. But I just don't.
Okay, but tell me this. But what I'm trying to say to you. Okay, you haven't done this thing yet. That you haven't got these girls pregnant and so forth. Are you an exception?
Am I an exception? No, yeah. I've got friends that are like me as well.
No, the majority of guys. Did you go up on a council say no?
I got a question.
I've got a new one.
Huh?
I've got a new one. Yeah.
So the majority of boys are they like you?
I got a question, man.
They're not like you. The whole
you
discussion.
You don't know the.
Okay, this discussion. What are we talking?
You're generalizing.
What are we talking about? What are we talking about now? This discussion is about the epidemic of simple
violence. You're generalizing. You don't know the people that.
Okay, why are we having this discussion? Why are we having this discussion?
We're going in a circle.
What's the discussion? What's this?
If you don't ask questions, we will go in a circle.
So let's see. Okay, so with what you're saying here, you're asking them like you don't, but you're the exception. I want to ask you. I'm not an expert. I don't have statistics, but I got logic and I've seen some things. And I lived in Muslim countries. People there, they're human like us. Everyone's human, right? People make mistakes. People are not perfect, right? Now, those guys can do the same things that you're saying, except that they'll be punished, maybe severely. And maybe they don't do it because of the punishment, not because they're more moral. You know what I'm saying?
That's true. That's true.
First of all,
that's true.
Either way,
what was the question?
He was saying that you could be in a Muslim country and they don't do it. But it could be because they get punished. But first of all, I'll be honest with you. The vast majority of Muslim countries don't have Sharia law anyway.
Hold on.
I don't think there is a country that has Sharia law.
Not fully. Yeah, right. But look, what I'm trying to say to you is this.
What do you mean not fully? You can't have
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. You can have certain things from Sharia law.
Yeah. Like, can you have half of the Quran?
Excuse me. You can have certain things from Sharia. I'm not saying you should. I'm not talking about what you should. I'm talking in practically. For example, you may have certain programs on the TV in Saudi or other countries, yes? That Islamic law you're not supposed to have on the TV. But you can still, a person who commits fornication can still get flogged.
So they're not hypocritical.
But they're still not implementing Sharia fully.
Oh, excuse me, I never said that though. You're saying that you can have aspects of Sharia law and then you can have other things that are in the country that are not supposed to be in the country. You can have both. Excuse me, is flogging the fornicator from Islamic law, yes?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Is having is smoking shisha from Islamic law? Okay. I'm sure in Saudi maybe you can go and do shisha, yes. But that doesn't mean they don't stop flogging people for doing fornication.
Because they're hypocrites.
You understand?
True. They are.
We're all hypocrites to some degree.
Well, then they shouldn't preach that they have.
Excuse me. Look, what I'm trying to say to you.
It's legit.
Excuse me. You could be a father, yes. And you could say to your children, don't shout at each other. And in general, your wife or your girlfriend,
can we wrap this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Where's my drink?
I left it right.
Oh, it's here.
It's gone.
So it's cool. Okay. You could be a father, yes, or a boyfriend, yes, who's been with his girlfriend for 10 years, which doesn't exist. But what I'm trying to say to you.
Doesn't exist?
In general, no, it doesn't.
I've heard of it, yeah.
It's not common, is it?
Okay, I don't know where you're going with that, because
let me answer
divorce
the
rates are super high.
Let me answer the question. What I'm trying to say to you. You could be a father. You could be a father and you could tell your children, yes? Don't shout at each other. Now generally your wife or your girlfriend, yes? You don't shout her down. But for some reason, yes, you're stressed about work, you've got to rush, you're in a rush, and you shout at her. That doesn't mean that in general you're not a good father. You slipped up and done something wrong.
Okay.
Yes? So I'm saying, in most Muslim countries, like of course in Saudi, you do adultery, you get flogged. No, you're stoned to death. Yes, you're killed. In Saudi, if you commit adultery, you get flogged. Okay.
Blasphemy.
Yeah, blasphemy. But what I was trying to say to you, but most countries like Morocco, like Egypt, like Tunisia and all these different countries, they don't have to know that if you fornicate, you're going to get flogged.
But they should.
Oh no, but yes, but the point I'm trying to say to you, in most of the countries that you're talking, the Muslim countries that you've been to,
yeah,
there's not some Sharia over them forcing them to get married. But still in the Muslim countries, yes, people generally get married and stay together for life. So what I'm trying to say to you, look, I asked you I said as a non-Muslim, growing up in a council state, I've seen this repeating circle of single mothers and runaway fathers. I became Muslim and I got married and I'm happy with that, yes? Now what I'm trying to say to you, I said what's your solution to the
way of living was a solution for all the challenges you're describing.
Right.
Even though you're not religious in that sense and you don't believe in what they believe and how they believe it, would you say it, just on that merit we should implement?
No.
No.
Because you'd be enforcing a religious belief on people that don't accept it. Even if it was good.
Okay. See the bias? See the bias?
Yeah, the bias of freedom of choice.
Let me jump on. Let's get something.
So everybody can choose what they believe.
So what if scientifically, and this is obviously a hypothetical, what if scientifically their beliefs was proven, as in like, so just stop me if I'm wrong, there's a creator.
What do you mean their beliefs? Oh, like God is proven.
So there's a creator, and the creator has a way of living. If the creator was proven scientifically, would you think that would be then worthy of something we should implement? Or even then you'd think, no.
Can't force it. So if, like, I can't force you to say certain words.
You haven't. You said you can't force it.
No, you can't. Of course you can.
So what I'm saying is, if God was, if Allah was true and made all the universe and made yourself an earth, would you think that would allow him to be worthy of being followed in the sense of he should absolutely be followed? You think you should have freedom away from
him? I'd be stuck at the precipice of having freedom of choice and then it being forced on me. Right there.
It's contrary to what you said earlier.
Am I?
Yeah, because you said that, I said to you, in this country, the problem was wrong with this country that it's teaching YOLO and that a man, one of the things we define ourselves is by how many goals you have, yes? So in
I'm not saying that's great.
I'm not saying you said it's great.
Okay.
So what I'm trying to say to you, I say society, TV, movies and stuff like that, individuals, the star, the man has lots of...
Hit that point, bro.
Yeah.
You see how I hit that point? Have you noticed I asked a question? Yeah. Hit that point.
Okay, so, but the point I'm trying to say to you, you said, okay, should men be allowed in this society to just go clubbing every week, sleeping with different girls, and over a span of his lifetime, he's got like 9 or 5 different girls pregnant, and he's just abandoned them. Then should there be a legal punishment for that, or should he just be free to do what he wants? Or should it be enforced?
Okay, there is already a legal punishment for it. And I would
say it should be enforced.
I'm not, you're right, well, there's two different things. One is a law system mandated by religion, and the other secular law is completely different.
So you can enforce a law,
sure, you can, if you have to enforce
it. So if it's not religious, you can enforce it, but if it's secular, you can enforce it.
Yeah, because it can be changed, and because it's decided by the choice of people, not arbitrarily.
But this is what I'm trying to say.
You know me.
You're saying that you can enforce secular laws, yes?
Yeah, because they can be changed.
Okay, but the problem is being forced on someone, yes?
Because you have to. There have to be limits on freedom in society for it to function correctly.
No, wait. No, but the whole thing is, you're saying religion should be because it's forced. But say it's right. Say, because I don't believe, yeah, that just a man should be allowed to sleep around with as much girls and get them pregnant, yeah? And as long as he can afford it, he can just pay him off. So are you saying that if a man is rich, yes, that he can just keep on sleeping around with girls, getting them pregnant, and just paying them off?
If the woman lets him and he has the money, probably, man, because it's going to be a tiny, tiny minority, okay, isn't it? Is it going to be 100 million people?
So say the man, guys? Say the women are not happy with it.
And then it's a problem, eh?
Okay, so all these women living on council estates and stuff, they're not happy that these guys, yeah, have had a baby with them, which is part of their thing, but it takes two to tango. They're not happy, yes, that they've been a father and mother, they're working 3 jobs in this area, their life is hell. So what should be the punishment for that?
Punishment? I don't know.
So until then, tough.
No, we can work something out, but I don't think it needs to be religiously mandated.
Okay, so why do women are living their life and they're having to work 3 jobs, yes, and they're having to come home and raise them with manners and dress them and feed them and iron and all this stuff, we just working stuff out what they do with this grief, life and grief. That's not fair.
Right, many things are not fair. But we got to do it, I have to say, we got to do it in a rational way.
So are you up at night trying to work this out?
Maybe I am.
You're not? Are you?
You don't know me, bro.
Okay, are you up at night working this out?
Do you think...
Do you
think this is the first time I've thought about this?
I can think about different things walking down the street. I'm saying...
Because we all talk in circles, right? Because you believe something, you don't believe something. But you've identified
I'm talking about rights. You were saying if I implement that, I said no, I give my reason why. That's not a circular argument.
No, I'm sorry for the conversation.
Okay. Right?
So what I'm saying is, you understand that the reason why he wants to enforce laws is because because he believes in the supernatural power that made everything, and he believes that because that power exists.
Could be. Yeah. There could be more motivations for it.
Well, is there any more motivations behind you believing that Allah made the entire universe and us? Therefore, meaning what he says. Is there any other motivation aside from that?
Well, I have a thing when I see human beings. I see like my friends who ain't a Muslim that I need to sleep around with. Their life is basically fine because they can just keep out raving. They still are raving, and if a girl gets pregnant, they just can ignore her. But for the girl, and she's responsible because she shouldn't have allowed a person to have a relationship with her after just meeting them in a nightclub.
Right.
Yes. But the whole thing is that it's unfair to a woman because the women are just getting abused.
Right. I agree, it's not a good situation.
But it's easy for us good guys to say, oh, it's not a good situation. But we don't have to raise it. The life of a single mother is and I'm not a woman. But just the life of a single woman.
Can you see a solution outside Islam? So for example, you know this gentleman here.
Yeah.
By the way his position is, I don't think he's going to accept Allah as the creator of the universe right now. Forever.
Or you accept know. It imposed upon people.
Yeah,
as
there you go.
More
so can you think of, see with me, yeah. There's a way I think things might be good. Yeah. Because I try to look at the tangible solutions within someone's particular paradigm. So within his paradigm, how would you have some like, not that he's a well, parent with older children, I don't know. But how? Yeah.
Baby,
how would
baby
you,
daddy.
Outside of Islam, would you tell him to live Islam?
This is why I think he's losing an uphill battle. The reason why he's losing an uphill battle is because he's one person and you have a society with psychologists behind it, graphic designers behind it, scholars behind it, who, even though capitalism has nothing to do in theory with how you live, there is a philosophy, and that society is we are just consumers. Yes, the more material things you have, so
you're not going to give him any solutions.
I'm saying that I think.
I'm glad you're arbitrary.
Yes,
I get lost.
Okay, I'm saying to you, I believe it's only going to get worse.
Okay, maybe
because the music industry is not
going. Maybe I don't disagree.
Because the music industry is not going away.
Let me ask you a question.
The music industry.
This guy. Yeah. He's got.
What's your name, by the way?
William.
Jason or Hussein.
William.
Jason or Hussein.
Yeah. Hi, Hussein.
William's got loads of children and he's on the girl, right? For some reason, he
got. Everything from Yago Benjamin.
Come, man, say it straight. Man, don't listen to BBC. Man, don't listen to ITV.
No. Repeat myself again. Can I get a hand time? No, stop. Did they listen carefully? As I said to you over there, Andrew. The point is now,
why you jumping
translation? Once we agree,
translation.
On something,
why you holding this translation? He's just a liar.
Yeah.
No, that's all he says.
Remember that.
No.
The sin is always going to be.